someone. I made a start on doing the outside today. You can ignore those pillars there where the inherent problems with some of these pillars have origins that are not in the center of the model. So I could leak test the map. I had to just basically find all the ones where basically these origins are out in the void, and you can see one there, one there, one there. Anyway, I did basically a detail run of the all floors, basically the basement, the sorry, can't flip in map and talk at the same time. Basically all the big rooms, I added some ceiling beams, as you can see. I think it adds a bit of detail. Added all the lights now, so basically the basic lighting is done. It probably requires some tweaking. I think we have to get, so I have to create some skins for you for whichever direction the moon is in. I'm a great advocate of having the moon shine in from the right side and not all the windows. So for example, if it's going to be shining from the front of the building, all these windows will have light coming through them, so it'll come through there, not through there, or through that window, obviously through that window, etc, etc. You get my point. There's more roof beams. Start tweaking the flooring. I'm sure we've got some other flooring textures in 206 that I can port over for this map. We definitely need some more. There's plenty of other wallpaper textures, which I'll just have to make you up some skins, because it's a bit boring seeing the same old skins time again. Tweak the bathroom a bit, give it a better floor, but again, it palette matches. These, you know what, I think I'll change them to that. Yeah. What else? Done that. Yeah, you've already seen all of this. Still haven't built that flipping table. One of the things that's put the kibosh on it is these two decals I created don't fucking work properly. Basically, I'm not a texture whiz by any stretch of the imagination. So sometimes I get it right first time, sometimes I don't, and I have to figure out what I've done wrong. I think what's wrong is the alpha channel. I've balked it somehow, because the black bits that are there, they're appearing black in game as well, and they shouldn't. They should be transparent. So I'll probably have to get somebody else to look at that for me. Did the ceiling in there. I still have to make one of these windows openable. I think it's going to be one of them. Anyway, you've seen the kitchen beams in there. Basically, every room that has a big enough space needs support from an architectural point of view. So I've put beams in there. where are we? Basement's missing. There we go. These are the rooms for the servants. So one of them is going to be the cook, the other one's going to be the butler or something like that, and then the guards barracks. But again, this free for you to do what you like once these create. You can add more if you want, or put bunk beds in here. That's the boiler room. You already know about that one, but I've put dirt decal patches, as you can see there, in between each of the beams, etc. It's an easy thing to do. Basically, it's a single patch that covers that entire brush, and then I've just gone it 2x2. Right, and the outside. I made a start on that before I had my dinner. Let's ungroup that selection. Apply that skin. Blam! So this is basically, this mimics the outside, the texture you use, well, mimics, it is the outside texture you used before on your building. I don't know why you've got that roof texture on there. Well, maybe I put it on there by mistake. I don't know. But that's basically what the outside looks like now. I've started, basically, I did all of the ground floor. So all the matching text, all the matching outsides, match up with the inside windows verbatim. Now the thing with these modules, you can change the module type easily. So at the moment it's wall 01. You can make it to wall 02 if you wanted to, like that. Just to add a little bit of variability in the outside. The only thing that that bugged me a little bit was trying to line up all the outside ones to provide that same gap that I've got on all the interior modules. I tried doing it and then they all stopped lining up properly. So basically I think they're one unit there, so they're grid. Oh, they're grid 4, so they're one unit of grid 4 away from the edge. It's just fine because the ceiling brush, the cork brush that goes around the outside, fits neatly in the middle. So, problem solved. The only place where there is no window and there's no hole is ones like that where I've had to just duplicate the window model. So those ones you're not going to be able to make openable. Or if you do, you're going to have to be sparing because I'll have to create a new model for you. Right, first floor. Again, just copied everything from that I put on the ground floor and moved the up one. And there's the little, I put a little window into the secret room as well. Right. Oh, interesting. I don't have a ceiling wall between the two guest rooms. Now we do. Don't strictly need to do this, but I kind of like it because it just gives it a nice clean, you know, when you go from one floor to the other. And the reason you're not seeing the beams here, because I've attached them to the first floor, the whole idea of working with layers is you're hiding the layer above it in its entirety. Right, so let's continue on with the outside. I don't know if there's anything specific I have to let you know. You've got multiple skins for these modules, by the way. I just picked the one that matches the same outside that you used. So they're all the different skins that you can use for outside. Right, so that's the I suppose the roof area. How thick have I made that? Too thick. Well, this will be fun, trying to create a roof that because it can't be one big roof like that. Let's put the outside back again and see what I can come up with. What can I do? Because we have basically roof models, but they're not designed for a building of this size. Where's the roof section? There's roof trim. There we go. I guess I could do the old resizing trick on these. Let's see what that looks like. Otherwise, it'll be fun. trying to get multiple smaller models to line up. Let's put the first frog back. I might have to put some spacers or change the texture. I think get away with that, I think. Now, is that exactly the same size as that one? No, it's smaller. So let's go another thing at grid 4. But lining up is going to be fun. And I still think it's not the same size. I think it's still too small. Happy days. This is where using numbers to make these resizable rather than this resizing technique would probably be better, and I might revert to that, because every time you clone something it dynamically changes size. Watch, if I clone it, it goes back to the original size again. That might be one for Grebo, I think. And the other problem will be where's the edge of the bloody it's there. It's sticking out by that much on this side. Yes, it is. Trying to get a spacer to fit in between that now. Those are going to work. Because there seems to be no way to choose your scale. Which axes you scale on. It basically just changes the whole thing on every... on every axis. Whereas when I scale it using numbers, the rotation, that I could scale it in various I think I said this before, in just one direction. Now if I try to get the, where is it, model the girl that goes in between the two roofs, I'll bet you it won't line up. It'd be the wrong here, that one. Oh, hang on, there's a way I could do this. Just going to quickly try something first. Seems to fit in there and get away with it, sort of. Ah, oh, fucking deselect! Yeah, look. It's massively overlapping the other roofs, but you can't quite see it because it's such a irregular texture. You can't see it from the ground. So it might get away with doing that there. Now the fun part will be yeah, putting a roof across here. Now if I use them, yeah, that isn't fucking, that's gonna work, is it? Oh, this will be fun, and I really don't want to have to create custom flipping roof textures for this. If I can do this with numbers. So it's definitely not 1.5, that's not twice as big. Well, 1.5 times as big. Fair enough. I can work with that. And then when I clone it, it doesn't bloody resize. So I'm going to go with that for the roof stuff because the player's never going to get up here anyway. And the benefit of that is everything snaps the grid, as opposed to the resize model method. So probably get away with it for internal models, but not for external models like this. The other thing, can I use two of them there? Yeah, I was going to try and resize one, but then the textures would all get screwed up. So we'll go this way. Let's make sure that's exact. I'm going to just clone that. Is that on the edge? Yep, it is. Good. This one, don't think this one is though. No, now it is. Oh, look at that. Happy days. Nice, only a tiny bit of overlap there. And no one's going to see that because no one's going to be up there. And now what I can do is this. Now, the bit is, how do I fill up those gaps? Like that. Look at that, all nicely lines up. Happy days. Alright, let's put the first four black. Nice. I think what I'll do though is I'm gonna Come on, hide. Seriously? What the fuck am I seeing? Ah, the basement. I think I might put some spaces along the middle. Like that. With some normal sized versions of the roof texture, I think. I'll try it without and see what happens. Okay, all lines up nicely with the grid as well. Love it. Now, is there a bigger version of this one? No, 256 is all there is. Back again, move this out. Is it the ceiling? Get rid of the first floor, it needs to seal up against the edge of that. And I think it is. Let's go back one. Right, first floor back. Nice. Now I'm not worried about that bit of roof because I'm going to do this. I'm going to clone, keep the sizing the same, then change the model. There's a piece of roof. Where is it? It's trim. It's like that one there where it comes off the edges. In fact, let me... No, I can't... No, can't do that, so I'll undo that. Where is the little bit of roof? Come on. The trim, I know I saw it. There we go. Is that just the right length? Yes, it is. But again, problems with the flipping origin being miles away. But so there's nothing we can do about that now. Right. Go. Look at that, even lines up with that beam just there. Nice! I think I'll probably move this roof bit over a bit to accommodate these roof bits. Let's go over grid 3. Nice. What I could do is I can clone. Let's move that in a smidge. Ah, fiddlesticks. How am I going to do the trim? Can I poke this roof into there? No. Looks like I'm going to have to... I've got some brush that I created for... Thingamabob. Elixir. That duplicates that model, so I can probably steal that from there. This bit, and we can probably add a window to it to get a bit of variance. Oh yeah, I can do that with this one, can't I? There's another version of that model that has two little wings on it. That one there. Let's see what that looks like. Yeah, we can't do that because it pokes through the flipping ceiling. Fiddlesticks. So that'll have to move. I must have had that just wrong. Oh yeah, it's not that far enough. Okie dokie. Not a problem, because it gives those spaces behind it a bit more space. Which is grand. Or the single spacer behind it, I should say. Happy days. Does that mean these roof bits are poking into the room as well, though? No. No. Happy days. No pokey pokey. Those spaces are, though. Does that mean I've got to raise them up a bit? No, I think that tavern is looking decidedly better. There we go. So there's the front of it. Well, that window, then, not having one there, looks a bit weird. I might flip that round so the windows match up, line up on the front. And for some reason, even though that's got lit windows, I'm going to have to check it in game because it's not showing, and it could be just a skin problem. Or a, well, if it doesn't show in game, then it's definitely there's something wrong with the skin. What was I originally looking for here? There was these with windows in it. I'm sure there was. Maybe not. I'll have to place a clone a window up there. Is it? Because you can see the gap between the. Can you? Yeah, you can. But not on the unlit version. Nope, so. Clearly needs to tilt ever so slightly. Would the player see that from down there? Well, let's apply the skin to it. Blam. It does the weird texture thing there as well. You said you wanted one of those windows to be openable. Right, so there's our roofs. Now the thing to do with all of these is to make them non-solid because collisions. So no click model. Plus the player's never going to get up there, and no shadows. So we don't get weird effects as the player goes through the map. Right, what am I seeing there? Yeah, this is my OCD with the annoyancing with the annoyancing annoyances with the map. Doesn't really matter because the players are safe. Player's not going to get up there. But if the player does get up there, we can just put some boarding up there. Just experimentally placed these pillars. We're going to have to get more of them placed. It's the whole roof thing, isn't it? Oh, I know what I can do. Do that, can't I? Happy days. Do the same thing on the other side. Grand. Always fill out these little gaps, or I can just resize those columns to fill in the little gaps. Oops. I have to put a pillar there. I'm going to clip into that. Ooh, almost. Would you have one there? Let me hide it. Yeah, we'll remove that one. We'll just have them on the corners, thusly. And the joins between the two roofs. Roofs. Nice. And then doing the opposites. Right, that's the first detailed pass of the outside done. And I think it's looking quite spanky actually. Again, you can change the skins on all of these like you saw me do. I think if you're going to let the player get up, where we're going to put a ledge or something along some of these. I think it might create a drain pipe or something. I know I did read the Jeffrey's readable, so we'll have to come up with some way of explaining how the player gets up there. Right, let's draw some so I'm going to make it three grids away. As in the outside edge of the can always trim this down later. As in the garden, sorry, this is the garden floor. Why is it so bloody thick? Oh, something went awry there. I'm going to have to put some trim along the bottom of the building. I think I'll maybe do something with stone. Right, let's put unfilter everything and start moving. The other thing as well that hasn't been done, and I will do a video on that as well, is monster clipping. Right, so there's the outside. Now, city wall wise, yeah, I'm gonna have to think about this. because I want it to some parts of it to be street and other parts to be garden. Let's show you the shed. In fact, yeah. I think we used the shed that was used in what the hell is it called? No One Among Thieves. This is the same garden shed, but I can't remember where my copy of No One Among Thieves is, so we'll just grab it from this map instead. Yeah, you guys have probably never, well, it's probably been a while since you've seen this. But how's this for a mansion? Yeah, hopefully this campaign will see the light of day. Look at that. Flipping monster. I've done a few years work on this thing, but the original stuff that was here was dram. How's this for a garden? Monster. Anyway, the thing we need is, oh, by the way, you should recognize this. This is where I got the lava pit idea from for Gatehouse. This thing's monster. All custom modules and patches created. Right, this is the, I think it's this. Yeah, forest area. Is it in this one? Or is it here? Ah, there it is. Or is it? Is this the garden shed? Yeah, garden shed with a tree growing out in the middle of it. So yeah, I don't think we can use that one. No, so it's not in this map. So which bloody map is it in? I steal the gardener's house. Yeah, this is the, a bunch of things are in this map that are now de facto prefabs from the very beginning. Dram created them. Yeah. We'd use this as a garden shed. It's probably a bit too big. One, two, three, four. A grid seven. 1, 2, 3, 4. Yeah. Could go there, I guess. All right, it's got to be a different map. No, it's got to be in No Honor Among Thieves. Hopefully I've got a copy of this map somewhere. Otherwise, I'm going to have to download the whole thing again. Let's see if I can insert it in game. So, architecture, buildings. Where are we? Garden shed. No, well, that's one I created. We could always use that. What's in there anyway? Wow, that's basic. Yeah, that's not the one I was thinking of. I know we've got it here somewhere. Where is it? No, that's my garden shed. It's going to take me a while to bloody find this. Yeah, that's it is what you think it is. One of these days somebody's going to use that map or use that model. It'd be brilliant. Who created that? Castle facade? What? We have a castle facade. Who built this? Oh, this is me. Oh, yeah. This was something I created for behind closed doors and it never got used. There's a bit here that you'll recognise. You'll recognise that gate. And I never built that thing behind it. Yeah, I closed it off. Or did I? I can't remember. I don't think I put this, but yeah. This was going to go in BCD. It was a massive castle and I never got around to finishing it. Yeah, got rooms and everything. Has it got a... yeah, that has a foyer. Foyer. Yeah. Yeah, never got around to finishing that. Well, it's a prefab. It's in my thingamabob. It's in my Mega Drive, so people are welcome to download it. Alright, fine. I could be here all bloody day, or I could just download the flipping No One Are Among Thieves and extract the garden shed from there instead. Look at this airship. I'm just curious to see what it looks like. Oh, full of missing models. Oh, this is going to take a while. What are we up to? 50 minutes. All right, let me finish doing the outside, and I'll come back to you tomorrow or the day after.